Please come to order. Welcome to our public hearing tonight. Good evening. Welcome. I am Randy Guy, President of Commissioner of St. Mary's County. I'd like to introduce the other commissioners joining us at the table. Sitting to my right, Representative First Commissioner District, which includes Ridge, Piney Point, St. George's Island, Tom Jarbo.
Good evening.
Next, Commissioner Jarbo, Representative Second Commissioner District, which includes Leonardtown, Hollywood, Mike Hewitt.
Good evening.
To my left, Representative Third Commissioner District, which includes Charlotte Hall, 7th District, Golden Beach, John O'Connor.
Evening.
And Representative Fourth Commissioner District, which includes Lexington Park, Southern California, and Great Mills, Todd Morgan. See, next to Commissioner Morgan at the end of the table is Dr. Rebecca Bridget, our County Administrator. On my immediate right is Sharon Ferris, our recorder for tonight. Ms. Amy Carter, who you don't see, is behind the glass here. She's our video producer, so please smile when you come forward. Please turn your cell phone off or on vibrate. When you come to the microphone to speak, please come down to center aisle. And remember, this meeting is being televised, so you need to speak clearly and directly into the microphone for recording purposes. This public hearing tonight is for the Behavioral Health Services Administration. Sign-in sheets were provided out front. If you have not signed in and wish to speak, we ask that you sign in now, please. We will now have a presentation from Dr. Rebecca Bridget, our County Administrator.
Thank you, Commissioner President Guy. On March 8th, 2016, the Commissioners of St. Mary's County requested a public hearing seeking public input on the Behavioral Health Services Administration report dated December 2015. Background issues for you to be aware of is in April of 2015, the regional supervisor for the Department of Health and Mental Hygiene suggested that St. Mary's County consider transitioning the Behavioral Health Services Administration from the St. Mary's County Department of Aging and Human Services to the Health Department, since many other jurisdictions support this model and the vendor could receive payments more timely. Two stakeholder groups were held to explore the idea. We gathered information from Charles and Calvert counties, as well as received technical assistance from DHMH. The purpose of the meetings were to identify the appropriate lead agency to manage and monitor the Mental Health and Substance Abuse Services Administration for St. Mary's County. This public health issue is largely led statewide by the local health departments, and DHMH intends to complete the state integration in FY 2017. Attached in board docs for your information is the report, the legal notice, which was posted on March 23rd and 25th, jurisdictional comparison, the news release, which was posted on March 22nd, and the informational memo that summarizes the project. So that concludes my presentation, unless there are any questions.
Yeah, quick question. In April 2015, you say they contact you. Is that in writing?
Probably an email, but I can get that for you. Her
Please.
Name's Anita Ray.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Any other questions, anyone? Okay, we will now open the hearing for public comments. We ask that you keep remarks to 3 minutes. And the first speaker is that Amy Henderson. Please come forward and give your full name and address, please.
Good evening. I'm Amy Henderson. I live in Leonardtown. I became involved in the mental health services arena about 10 years ago. I have a close family member who has serious mental illness and became a volunteer mental health advocate and was heavily involved in that for several years. I haven't been as involved recently. I don't know all the ins and outs about the proposed changes, but I do know that sadly, some of the word on the street among other counties is that our county is kind of a laughingstock with how our mental health services are organized, and that's not any reflection on the people who are tasked with delivering the services. But I do recall that about 8 years ago, when the services were provided through an organization called Mental Health Authority, the Public Health Services Mental Health, there were about 12 people in that office. And when the change was made to bring mental health under the umbrella of the county, that staff was reduced to about 3 people. And so we had 3 people scrambling around trying to cover the bases to take care of a very needy service sector. And they were often overworked and frustrated. I imagine that's still the same. Then I was on the Human Services Board for a while. And without any consulting to members of that that board, who were all the most knowledgeable people regarding mental health and those types of services. The change was made to incorporate the Human Services Department under the Department of Aging. So imagine if you have someone in your family who is becoming psychotic, behaving irrationally, needing care, and you're desperate to find that care. Where would you look? In the public health services, online. Go to the website. Would you look in the public, in the Department of Aging? I don't think so. Mental health, behavioral health, drug addiction, drug abuse, alcohol abuse, those are all public health issues. And they deserve to be under the umbrella and with the guidance of capable public health providers and under that oversight. And I know that Dr. Brewster does a wonderful job for our health department. She provides cutting edge services and information for people. And I believe that that's where people usually think to look for those kinds of services. And so it's my opinion that the recommendations from the Department of Health and Mental Hygiene should be followed, and that the mental health services and behavioral health services for our county should be under the health department. I also think that that would allow for coordination with the state better, and also to be able to access things like grants if those are ever available. So I thank you for your time and hope that you'll take my comments into consideration.
Thank you, ma'am. Appreciate it. Okay, next we have Mr. John Parlett.
Good evening, Commissioners. John Parlett, Charlotte Hall, Maryland. Thank you for the opportunity to speak to you this evening. I presently serve on the St. Mary's Adult Substance Abuse Recovery Court Advisory Board. And so we are engaged in mental health at that level, from drug addiction, alcohol addiction, and so forth. And to not to repeat the things that Amy just described, and I did not know Amy before tonight, I think she gave a great explanation of what generally folks in the community would expect to find and where they would go to look for services. The Office on Aging certainly has a big job to do taking care of their core mission. This was a portion of work that was handed to them at some point in time and is really not part of their core responsibilities. I think the Public Health Office is obviously a great location for this to be placed. It's also in complete accordance with what's happening around the state. I think 20 out of 24 jurisdictions currently have their health departments as the responsible party for the administration of these types of programs. I've read the entire report that Dr. Bridget provided you back some time ago. It appears that we did all the right things as a county in looking at what we're doing right, what we're doing wrong, what could be improved. That was all outlined in this report. And the consensus of that group after two meetings and a number of interactions was exactly that, to place the administration of this with the St. Mary's County Health Department and with our public health officer, in this case, Dr. Brewster. So I would appreciate your consideration in going in that direction. I think these folks have already kind of worked their way through all the weeds and figured this out, and I think that's the direction we should go in. So thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Parlett. Next, we have Michael West.
Good evening. My name is Michael West. I live in Mechanicsville, Maryland. I, too, serve on the Substance Abuse Recovery Court. I'm also a graduate of it. I stand before you today. I'm an alcoholic, and this year I will celebrate 4 years of sobriety, 2 years of tobacco-free, which all came through help that I received from Substance Abuse Recovery Court. And Dr. Brewster also sits on that board, and I think that the health department could and would, under Dr. Brewster, do a better job. Not that they're not doing a good job, but a more efficient job. You know, I don't know if you realize, but every 19 minutes, somebody in this country dies from an opiate overdose. Every 19 minutes. Since we've been in this room together, somebody died. And it's very serious. It's about 28,000 people a year. It starts out, you know, if you look at The United States makes up 5% of the population, okay? We, with that 5%, we take 80% of the opiates that are produced in the world. Our 5% requires 80%. These are just phenomenal numbers. It's very serious. We're not bracing for an impact. We're not, you know, getting ready for something that's going to happen. We're not getting ready for the water to rise. We're in the middle of it. It's here. And, you know, like everyone else has been saying, I think that the health department would do a much better job. Today, at a summit, a drug summit, the President of the United States vowed to ask Congress for $1.1 billion to help with this epidemic. It's here. It's real. It happens all the time. In the last 2 years, I've lost two good friends. They're dropping like flies. This is serious. And we need to try to do the best that we can, and I think that that would be the best. So thanks for hearing me.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Next, we have Julia Randall.
Hello. My name is Julie Randall, and I live in Lexington Park, Maryland. Good evening, Commissioners, Dr. Bridget. Thank you for the opportunity to speak on this very important topic. I am the treasurer of Walden and represent Walden's board tonight with my remarks. The majority of our board is here tonight in the audience. I must strongly oppose the proposal to move behavioral health management services oversight from the county to the health department. The history of oversight of behavioral health services in the county reflects a number of changes over the years. Walden has gone from receiving grants directly from the state to receiving oversight from the county, to the transfer of that oversight to the health department in 2006, back to the county oversight through the Department of Aging and Human Services. Each move that involved oversight of vital community services created a potential for loss of critical knowledge of service delivery, as well as loss of system contacts at the local, regional, and state level. In addition, changes in the responsible party for oversight caused loss of relationships with service providers and subsequent degradation in services, while the parties got up to speed on changes imposed. The current recommendations to move oversight of mental health and substance abuse services to the health department creates the risk of system loss. Turning over services for behavioral health management to the state-run health department will obscure accountability to the citizens for behavioral management services and reduce the flexibility we have at the local government level. The Board of County Commissioners, in its comprehensive plan, accepts responsibility for behavioral health as a local government requirement. Transferring the authority and requirement to provide behavioral health services to the health department transfers that responsibility as well. In fact, in my opinion, that's not what our comprehensive plan envisioned. The county's comprehensive plan, Chapter 12, specifically calls for the Department of Human Services to coordinate the county's participation in a comprehensive integrated system of behavioral health management. When Chapter 12 was added to our county's comprehensive plan, behavioral health management was one of the foundational requirements of that chapter. It was recognized at the time that the county had a major stake in providing our citizens with behavioral health services, just like we have a requirement to provide other services to our citizens, including safety, transportation, land use, and other things. With the continual increase of drug use in our county, we have seen the need for an integrated system of behavioral health care, and that has become more critical. I feel the criticality of these services indicates the need for an even stronger county role in behavioral health services management, not less. Another consideration is that of cost. Would a change be cost neutral? If not, how much more or less would the health department model cost us, long term and short term? We've been down this road before, commissioners, and the result was not cost neutral. Each change in oversight mentioned before incurred unanticipated costs. And in fact, if memory serves, when oversight was transferred to the Health Department in 2006, the additional cost was over $80,000, funds that should have been going to treatment for St. Mary's County citizens and not to administration. In conclusion, I and my fellow Walden board members feel moving oversight of behavioral health services from the county to the health department is not in the best interest of our county's citizens, especially those who need substance abuse and mental health services. The need for these services continues to increase, and the citizens depend on the county, as reflected in the comprehensive plan, to provide for the services necessary to meet those needs. The county, through the Department of Aging and Human Services, has achieved uniformity and standardization of service outcomes by collaborating with behavioral fund sources. It's focused on care coordination across the whole system of care in the county and provided a forum for collaboration to develop the best possible behavioral care system. The system we have in place today is working well. Given the criticality of the services to our citizens, we believe there is no need for change, and we are well advised to leave the oversight of behavioral health services where it is with the county. And I thank you for allowing me to speak.
Thank you, Ms. Reynolds. Okay, next is it Dr. Kathy O'Brien.
Good evening, Commissioners. My name is Dr. Kathleen O'Brien, and I live in Leonardtown, and I'm the CEO of Walden. Walden is 43 years old. We have been on our own, under the county, under the health department, back to the county, so you know we are very flexible. And at 43, it seems that we must be going through another midlife crisis. It's ironic that today I was the keynote speaker on comprehensive systems of care at the state at Shepherd Pratt, speaking to all of my colleagues in this field around how you create a comprehensive system of care, because St. Mary's County is the only county in the state of Maryland that has a complete continuum of substance abuse treatment. And not only that, we also, under our roof, have mental health and trauma-informed care as well and are nationally accredited. So we are the model that the state is looking to us as how do you have such a nimble system that is so comprehensive and so state-of-the-art. And it's because we have had the flexibility that we have. I understand why our regional director, Anita Ray, came down to St. Mary's County, because she was concerned that under the county government there is a lag time with getting our state grants. But for us, this has been the way business has been done. We've gotten used to that, we've accommodated it. We're an organization that is fiscally responsible, and we have safeguards in place so that we don't have cash flow crises. We've been operating like this for decades. We did have our community stakeholders meetings, and I think we had some robust conversations. But Walden is the only organization that is financially impacted by any changes in oversight, and we're not given that opportunity to really speak to the impact of that, so we're glad to have that opportunity tonight. There is an assumption that most jurisdictions are under the auspices of the health department, and we are very unique. In fact, we are not so unique. So when you talk about behavioral health, you're talking about two specialties, one mental health and one substance use disorder treatment. So of the 24 jurisdictions, mental health is managed under county government or quasi county governmental nonprofits in 14 of the counties. So only 10 jurisdictions are currently under the health department. And those are ones that continue to have clinical services in-house. Because until recently, substance use treatment was grant-based, and many health departments continued to provide those clinics, many are still located within the departments. But as we know, we are undergoing a tremendous change in our financing of this system. And that means that as a change to a fee-for-service, that is going to change as well. A lot of the conversation at today's conference was about that, how to get ready for that change and to get away from our traditional health department-based services. There's also the situation where we are nationally accredited. In speaking with DHMH today, they spoke about us having deemed status, which would mean we would not have local oversight in that regard, because we have national accreditation, which takes care of the clinical oversight that we have, and we would basically have fiscal monitoring.
Mr. Ryan, your 3 minutes are...
Oh, they're up?
Yeah. You can please wrap up real quick.
Okay, so I just want to give you what I would recommend is that that prevention, the health officer, I agree, should be the designated spokesman for public health. There's no debate that these are public health issues. We have many prevention and public education services in the county, and a lot of those initiatives are hard to follow because of that overlap, and I would propose that prevention and public education be housed in the health department for a more coordinated approach, and that we continue to look as this system changes at the state to recognize that this is not the time for us to be changing and going backwards, but to continue to move forward and be the leaders that we've become in this arena across the state. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay, next we have Ms. Ella Mae Russell.
Ella Mae.
Ms. Russell, do you want to speak?
You might want to tilt that microphone down since you have such a boisterous voice.
My name is Ella Mae Russell, and I'm the director of the St. Mary's County Department of Social Services. I have a very special interest in this whole process because in the year 2008, when welfare reform was created in the state of Maryland, one of the things that, and I was part of the writer of that, was to have services provided to those of us, those clients who come to us and who need to have help with substance abuse and other mental health issues. And special money was carved out of that that comes directly to serve the population that we serve. And that money is very important to us. We have a full-time person from Walden who lives in our agency, goes back and forth between Leonardtown and Lexington Park, and provides identification of issues for them and helps to resolve issues and works very closely with our staff and with our customers. It is through her being there that we are able to access all of the services of Walden without a cost to our customers because they don't have money to begin with. And I'm very concerned about how that will be impacted if any change is made. And it's my belief that the health department should be the prevention kind of person and not necessarily the provider of these services because our work does not end at 5 o'clock at all. The other thing is that I'm one of these people who keep everything and remembers everything from the past. And I just want you to think about considering, we used to have in 2008 created the Human Services Council that was very effective in this county. And they created that, the commissioners created it, because there were more than 20 nonprofits who were reporting to nobody and wanted to put together the services. That was very successful. And it ended because there was not adequate staff in the Office of Human Services to continue that. And I would encourage you to think about this, because it brought together everybody from transportation to housing to nonprofits and so on. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Next we have Mina Brewster, Dr. Brewster.
Hi, good evening, commissioners.
Good evening.
Mina Brewster, Leonardtown, Maryland. I'm not here to lobby for or against. I think I provided my input during the stakeholder process. I did want to clarify a couple of points that others have mentioned or identified. One, we are a local health department. While we do use state HR infrastructure, our mission is wholly local. We are here to serve our local county population. Our Board of County Commissioners serves as our Board of Health, which provides some of the governance for our organization. And our focus is wholly the St. Mary's County population and certainly all the health issues that are public health issues here in St. Mary's County. I trust whatever decision you'll make, I know will be in the best interest of this county. And as a health officer and as a St. Mary's County Health Department, we will do whatever the commissioners desire in this matter. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay. Okay, that's all we have signed up to speak, but if there's anyone else in the audience who did not sign up, who has wished to speak at this time, please come forward. All we need you to do is state your name and address, and you can speak your piece. Now is your time. Anyone else? It's not an auction, but it's going to go fast. Okay, thank you very much. Then the Commissioner of St. Mary's County will receive public comments on this matter for an additional 7 days. Comments can be mailed to the Commissioners of St. Mary's County at Post Office Box 653, Leonardtown, Maryland, 20650, or you may email them to csmc@stmarysmaryland.com. And believe me, we will be patiently waiting for any more comments on this. We have to make a decision, so your public comment is very helpful to help us make the right decision for all the citizens of St. Mary's County. At this time, we will now close the public hearing.
Can I ask just a question in generalities? It doesn't have to be answered this evening. Obviously, in my opinion, there's a lot of money moving around here. And not to be answered this evening, but I'd like to know what the effect will be in the long term on grant funding to fee-for-service. Because as we're watching the state government now and the federal government, it seems that as we watched our budget discussions today, grant funding is going down and fee-for-service is going up. And what will that do to impact the citizens of the county, not those that will be able to afford services, but more importantly, those that won't be able to afford services in the long run? And where, you know, from speaking for me and the board eventually, how that will affect the citizenry of this county. And I think to me, one of the things that I worry about is not those that can't afford, but more importantly, those that can't afford. And if this thing goes one way or the other, what would the cause and effect be on both sides of the equation? And that would help me a lot to sort of understand better what's going on, because obviously the board has a lot of things that we have to consider. This is one piece of it. And your inputs and anybody out there listening and talking, it'd be important to hear from you guys too, because I can tell you I'm a DOD guy, I'm not a health services person. So any help, I'd appreciate very much, so thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Yeah, no problem.
I think just for clarity on that, if Dr. Bridget, if you could put that into one clear message so we're not looking at six different varying opinions, one package together, sure, of comparisons, so we can take a look at that, so it's not just several different opinions, so we're looking at, yeah.
Sure.
And I would ask Ms. Harris, effects on your department, because some people would obviously be leaving your department, and how that will affect the citizenry as a whole would be appreciated also.
Anything else, other commissioners? Anybody? Okay. With that discussion being done, we will now close public hearing for public comments and close the public hearing.